Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Marije and I am from Junk Journal Addicts. Sorry that I wasn't on YouTube last week, but I didn't have much inspiration. So I thought I will take 1 week off to get my flow back. And this time I want to do some mixed media. I have this dye, it's from Sizzix and Tim Holtz, of course, 660220, and I will be using Distress mixed media heavy stock. It's also from Tim or Ranger, and I thought maybe we can do a spoken video because I want to use some Distress spray stain, and it's easier for me to explain if I'm talking about it. What do I do first? I have to use my water bottle, and here it is, with a little bit of blue water. Nah, okay. And I will be using for the spray Vintage Photo, Void Burlap. Shall I also use the new one? Let's see, where is it? Oh yeah, Scorched Timber, and it's still closed with the package. And I think some blue, or shall I use another color? Let's see, because I always pick the same colors. Redded Wood is a pretty one. And maybe some. What shall I do? Orange. Maybe a little bit of crushed olive. Shall I do that? Yeah. And bundled sage. So those are the colors I will be using. Let's place this over here with my spray bottle. First, I'm going to use my dye, and I want to use this one. So I'm going to cut this a little bit smaller. So if I place this here, yeah. Do I have some washi tape here so I can? So I have some washi. It's a very old washi, so perfect for to do this. Oh, and I think it's already another one. So if I place this, oh, I can hear a helicopter. Put this aside, and where are my plates? Over here. Okay, let's see. I'm placing this at the plate and then run it through the power boy. Oh, it's a little bit. What is this? Okay. A little bit wonky, but oh, that's cool. Not how it's possible it's so bobbly. I don't like that. Oh, maybe because the this is a little bit. Oh, that's great. We are going to do it again. And maybe is this too small? Yeah, it's a little bit small. Let's see. I think it is. I've ruined my magnetic mat. So stupid of me. But I think that's why this is hobbly bobbly. So we do it again, but I'm going to place, oh wait a sec, I have to remove all the little thingies. Maybe it's better if I place this here, or shall I do it now?
Yeah.
Is that beautiful? Wait a sec. I'm going to use not my Power Boy, but my big C6 Big Shot. And I have to order a new magnetic mat. Mat. Where are the plates? Then we are using this. Okay. Take two. Think over here. Okay, right back. Yes, this is better. Okay. Yeah, like this. Okay, what shall I do next? Shall I use another die or no? I think I want to place some, or shall I do that after? What shall I do? No. I'm going to pick some design paper. Let's see, which one shall I use? Maybe which color is going to work? Maybe this one, if I'm using also a little bit of orange. Oh, no, no. The other side is too beautiful. I don't want to ruin the other side. And is that nice if I use this? And no, you don't see much of it. But the color is white, so why not? Okay. I'm using this die. Where is it? This one. And I'm going to place it somewhere over here, so I can use the other part for something else. And I think like this. Okay, wait a sec. Okay, the first try did not work. And don't judge me, because I'm not a die person and I will never will be. But the second time, it's quite what I want. Oh, wait a sec, over here is... Oh, it's... Meh. Okay, I'm only going to use this part, so it's not what I want, but it's fine with me. And if I'm going to use some of the little children, yeah, something like this. Okay. We are going further. I think I'm going to place this here. And maybe this is not why. Oh no. Maybe it's cute when this is not completely cut out. So if I'm placing this here. And I think I will be using collage medium, and that is this one, the stress collage medium, but you can also use gel medium or something like that. Where is my... I'm going to use this little thing because I can't find my big brush. So we are doing it like this. Why not? Maybe a paper. Okay, let's place this at the back so I can put the glue everywhere I want and not ruin my table. And something like this. Yep. Okay. Place some gel medium on top so it really stick to the other paper, and over here I have to place some more glue. And let's place over here also some glue for protection of the spray, because otherwise the paper is going to suck all the spray, and that's not what I want. Maybe it doesn't work, but let's try it out and we will see. Okay. Yeah. You have to clean up your brush, you have to clean off your brush right away, because otherwise the gel medium is going to ruin your brush. And this is not the right way, I know, but it's a quick way and I don't want to walk to the sink to clean it, so I'm doing it like this. So, same result. Okay, let's dry this. Before we are going to add some spray. For this I'm going to use my craft tool, not my embossing tool, because the heat is now wider than the embossing tool. Embossing tool is quite strong. So that's why I'm going to use my craft tool. Okay. Yeah, it's dry. Let me see if you can see it. Yeah. And maybe it's nice if I'm going to place this with a little peek of an eye in the middle. Why not? And maybe there. That's quite cool. Yeah. No, it's scary. I think more like this, because otherwise you are seeing this part. Now, come on. There. Do you see it? And I'm watching Walking Dead right now. It's a TV show, a series on Netflix. And if I think if you're doing this, it's little bit Walking Dead, I think. yeah, just do. Oh, there is also an eye, and there's a little face. Ooh, quite creepy. Is there? Shall I do that, or is it too? Oh, he's a little bit grumpy. She is a little bit grumpy. No, don't put actually an eye in it. It's a little bit too, too creepy for me. Blub, blub, blub. Where's my scissor? Yeah, there. And let's cut this off. Just easy. like this, and then placing this over here. Yeah. I will be using my normal glue. So, okay, go away. And of course, you can also use gel medium, but I've just cleaned my brush and it's a little bit easier and it don't have to be very sticky, because I can place something over it and then it's secured. So yeah, okay, now the fun parts. Use some spray. Okay, first I'm going to add some water, not too much, a little bit. And I think I'm going to use first the... Oh, wait a sec, I have to remove the package. Yeah. Okay. Vintage photo. Let's do something there. And a little bit here and a little bit there. Frayed burlap. Let's do this here. And I don't mind that the people is are gone. Gone. A little bit where it would. Yeah, and a touch of crushed olive. Yeah, and bundled sage, why not? Also a little bit. And yeah, heat it up. Wait a sec. Because I've placed a gel medium on the top of my picture, so I can remove some spray here and there to, so that you can see the little guys. And I will show you here, you can see the little guys, but here, because I didn't place gel medium on top of the picture, you don't really see the little children anymore. And here you can see that I have also placed gel medium, so the spray does not connect very much, but I don't mind because I think it's a nice effect, and we can always place something else on it, maybe some crayons or whatever, or some glaze. Maybe I can use some glaze, also cool. So I don't mind this. Just play and see what happens. And if it works, ah, great. And if it doesn't work, okay. Okay. Okay, it's quite dry. And what have I learned about this technique, that if you place gel medium under something or on top of something, the distress spray doesn't attach. So here and there is some spots, but not quite, how do you say that? Doesn't cover all the thing. But this is also nice, because it's, this is very warm, lots of color, and this is heel clean. So the second time when I will be using gel medium, I'm going to place also some here, some gel medium. So this is, how do you say that properly, Then you have it here and here, so it's a match. It's balanced, if you know what I mean. But we are going to work with this. And yeah, it's not terrible. Maybe we can use some gesso, maybe. Why not? This is the black gesso from Amsterdam. If I can open the, let me, oh, because it's a little bit dry, yeah. And maybe, shall I add some, use my finger. And I just want to place a little bit on the edge, so I gently swipe my finger over the edge. Yeah. Not too much on your finger, so just tapping it off and a little bit. So over here. Very light, tapping it to make some contrast. If you just quite thin, slowly. Yeah, not too much. And a little bit maybe here. This is going to be a little bit darker. Yeah, okay. And a black finger. Yeah. Okay. And some white gesso. That's a big bottle. Yeah. It's from Winston and Newton Galleria Acrylic Mediums. White gesso. Not yeah, how do I say that? Normally white, normal white gesso. And at the dark spots I will place some white. For the contrast. Oh, that's too much. Yep. Yeah, I need some. Yeah, that's too much. Yeah. First I'm going to apply the white gesso and then with my other finger I will place it on another spot or wiping it out. Maybe, yeah. Yeah, like this. Okay. What shall I do next? This is the result so far. With the white and the black gesso. And over here. And I will cut this off. And I think I'm going to use some wobbons maybe. And I will stitch here and there. But first... is it nice because the embossing glaze is solid, so if I place this over here then it's quite I don't think that I will love that. Maybe we can use some, if I use paint it's permanent. No, that's not. Also maybe some oxide. We can put here and there some thing, but first I'm going to place some water on it. Just splattering it. So, okay. Just wait a minute so it can do its thing. And we didn't use the new color Scorched Timber. Where is it? Here. So I place some drops, not too much because it's a very dark color. Also some splatters. And let's see what it's going to be. Okay, let's dry it. Okay, now we have this result. Not quite done yet, so I think I will be using some oxide. But what shall I do? Shall I use the spray? Doesn't matter. But what kind of color? I think from the stone it's a nice color. Or shall I use lost shadow? That's all also a very cool color. You have to mix the bottle, this little bowl in it, and you have to shake it really good. And let's use this. Okay. Okay. And I'm not going to use it as spray, but I have to organize my ink pads. So if I want to have the lost shadow as ink pad, I have to look at all my ink pads before I can find it. So that's why I'm using this way. Mix it up here and just placing it around and heat it up. Okay, so I use another color and then you get this. It's already getting a little bit better, I think. I want to have a blue. Mix it up. And a little ball is... there it is. scratching something, some knots. Okay, not too much, a little bit there, little bit there, little bit there, and a little bit there. Yeah, and heat it up, dry it. Yeah, that's a beautiful color. That was oxide wedded wood, like the dark gray bluish, is it? Maybe a little bit of water so the splatter is not quite a full drop. Yeah, better. Do you see this? That's the new color wedded wood I've added. And also over here, not too much, but so here and there. It's a dark blue grayish color and I like it. And I think next time I will maybe using rubbons to place under the here under the dye. But yeah, okay. Because how do you say that? For me, this is not really quite connected with this side. So how shall I? Can you use to connect both parts? And I think I will be using the rubbons. And if you're placing the rubbons here and over this place, then it's more connected. Let's see. What do I have? London Bridge. Yeah. Or maybe only numbers. Yeah, but the numbers is not quite big or long. I think I will be using both. Okay. I have to be straight, of course. So I'm just checking if it's really straight. And I don't mind if the rubber is not quite... Oh, it is. This one more over here. And something smaller over here. Maybe this one. Do we have to place something here or shall I cut some off? Let's see. Let's see. And is it, or maybe is it? Yeah, that's not a problem. But is it too big or so? Yeah, then I have to. It's a little bit. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. That's better. And it's also a little bit here because it's not quite straight. And I can always add some gesso again. So this is now more balanced. Okay, and so I place here something. Number 9. Okay, that's better. And maybe here. Oh, go away. No, that's not the right one. Let's see. This one? Yeah, that's better. Okay. My distress tool with ground espresso, so I can darken the edges a little bit. I don't want to that you see any white, so that's why I'm going to place some ink over here, and then you get this result. No, okay. I think that the London Bridge is little bit too clean for my taste, so I'm going to use my tweezer to tear some ribbons so it's not quite that clean. More like this, so it's not clean clean. Do I have to add something more? Because do I miss something? Yeah. Of course, I'm going to stitch all around. Let's do that first. And then we are going to look if that's cool or not. Okay, I have stitched 2 times all around. And I've placed here some zigzag and over here some zigzag. And I think the only thing is missing is here. Quote, something like that. Okay, I thought maybe I can use this. It's a stamp from Postumus in Amsterdam. They also have a web shop. Maybe they have this. This is the B9348 number strip. Oh, sorry. Focus, please. Yes, there it is. And maybe I can use this and just a stamp. And then some... what shall I do? Embossing powder or... So I just use embossing powder, let's see what color. In my little box. Clear. Black is going to be very black. This one I've got new, liquid platinum. It's very beautiful. But I think for this, not quite suitable. Yeah, I think the clear. Let's do that. Then I have to use paper. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Oh, over here. Yeah. And. Fashion Fine Clair Nocturne Black. Is it? And there. Yeah. Okay. Heat it up with an embossing tool. Oh. And then you have this. Quite subtle. Nou ja, dat is better. Okay. What shall I do? Let's do first. And this and it's too, yeah, no, it's too big. Does that work? Where are my tweezers? Yeah. Yeah. this is not straight. No. Yeah. The other side. Oh no, 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 no. That's not cool. Not cool at all. Crap. All sides. Let's see if this is going to work. No. Okay. Is this the right size? Maybe I can cut. Maybe something like this. We're placing this over here. Yeah, let's do that. No. Come. No. Tape. Maybe we can place this here. What is that stupid? Or more like maybe we can remove the 8 or the beginning of the 8. Okay. Is that cool or is that stupid? Shall we place something under it? That's also a possibility. Let's see if I can grab some leather. this color or the darkest? No, I think this one. Does it work again? No. The battle with the glue. No. Okay, third one. Never used this before, so. Oh yeah. Oh, that's. No. This is prettier. Let's see. Yep. Okay. Yep. Do we have to add something more? Shall I? Wait a sec. I'm going to stitch here. No, and then this one. Back. Yeah. Okay. Now I've stitched over here with a zigzag. And I think that it's done. So this is the result. I will go here and we see the spots. Very cool. And then over here. Yeah. So this is the result. And yeah. I like it. Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for spending your time with me. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. Please thumbs up, like the video. And if you have any questions, please ask. You can follow me on my Instagram, Facebook group, Junk Journal Treasure, and of course, YouTube Junk Journal Addict. So have a nice day, my friends, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye!